So we're on to the next episode now, at least we should be. Unless, of course, I couldn't find a good time to stop. Which is great for me, because it means I could talk about the shows now. And people are coming on right now like, wow, Innkeeper, you remembered that? I've given up on that. I haven't seen your video in like 4 days. I've completely forgot. And that's how it works, because, you know, I upload them in 4-day intervals. Which isn't that long now that I think about it. It really isn't. I always have that feeling like, okay, I've got 3 videos done. That should last me a decent amount of time. Nope. No, it doesn't last very long at all, oddly enough. We'll just get rid of the skeleton, and then we'll continue with our lives. I'm pretty sure there is another skeleton lingering around, though. Bloody hell, Finette, you're taking so much damage. Right, let's have Farkas deal with this last one. You, Finette, can bugger off. And by that, I mean, are you level 20 yet? I remember when you were only level 3. Oh, how they grow old. Then again, you were level 10 before you went into proper combat. Or at least I believe so. You should have been. Where is the skeleton? Oh, he's right there. Camouflages so well in the terrain. With the terrain. Yeah, Mom. There we go. Good job. You can make your way back now. That spider acted as an alert. Oh. Oh, no, there's one more there. Wait, Farkas. You a lady, Farkas? You are, okay. I never noticed. I never accepted it. I mean, I suppose me just automatically registering you as a dude is, I suppose, not the right way to do things. But there we go, still. It's just Farkas. It's a dude. So, I know he is. That's my automatic assumption. Right there. I mean, any ladies right now called Farkas? To apologize. But then again, I don't know any dudes called Emily, so that might be a dude. Oh, it'd be funny if it was. Hold on a second, let's find out. I believe they are not. Let's just find out. Emily, where are you? There you are, Emily. Come on. Nope. You are, in fact, a lady. Okay, good to know. The trees have been cut down. I thought there were a bunch of dead lumberjacks then. I was like, what the fuck? All these stumps look really interesting to me. Some of them are even stuck in the ground. It's very odd. Like a very, very small cut there. Well, the forest over here is ready to go now, and we are running a little bit low on the old wood. So we are going to go ahead and chop down some more trees for the motherland, of course. As it is always going to be for the motherland and nothing else. Nor comrade. Nor motherland. Or something like that. There we go. So what did I watch? What have I watched? What am I? Who am I? What am I? Who am I? Something like that. Right, so we're going to shut down some trees, get the roofing done, and actually talk about the subject that I did repeat or tried to get into last episode, but was fully prepared to have a proper transition to the next episode without just sort of cutting through the discussion, as I usually do. So, shows as a kid that I watched. I remember watching Ed, Edd n Eddy, Courage the Cowardly Dog. There was another weird one as well. I remember watching this at about 5 in the morning, 5 or 6 in the morning with my brother. We'd get up early to watch something called Fly Tales or something like that. It was just a really weird cartoon about a fly and his tales of the day. No talking whatsoever, black and white. It was a cartoon, so it wasn't sort of weird. Well, it wasn't. It didn't look like something that came from the 50s. 50s? When did color become a big thing? I don't know, but there we go. From the 50s. Black and white show or film that looked like Night of the Living Dead. I believe that was... I remember watching that on a sleepover. It was really weird. I don't know why we watched it. We just thought, look at this! This is a zombies in it. And it did have zombies in it. It had very shit zombies in it. But it had zombies.
Call my standards.
Exactly. Of course, we didn't push the modern standard at that time anyway. Upon the film, we just thought, wow. This is production right here. That gun sound was the budget. That was pretty much all gone there. What else did I watch? Codename Kids Next Door, I remember that. Teen Titans, that was one as well. Anything else? There were others there. I'm trying to think. I can't remember that one. I didn't watch too many... what the hell is it called? Recess. That was one, Recess. And I really can't remember that other one with like the weird... Not the Muppets or whatever those other ones are. They're like very strange humanoid animals. Or animals projected in a human world kind of thing. Every day we're walking down the street or something like that. Everyone has an original point of view. I can't remember what it was called, but there we go. It's What a Wonderful Kind of Day. I know the theme, so that would probably be good enough for people. Maybe. I don't know. I imagine it would be. I'm really annoyed I can't remember it. I'm thinking of a name. That's what's coming up in my head. Like a fortune teller. I see a name. What else? What else did I watch? What was my favorite? I think Courage the Cowardly Dog, definitely my favorite. Just because of how creepy it was. You wouldn't see that kind of thing ever again. Courage the Cowardly Dog. That was scarring right now. I feel like that show prepared me for the internet. Just like as soon as things, weird shit came up on the internet, I was like, yeah, whatever. I'm unfazed. I watched Courage the Cowardly Dog at such a young age. Just, you know, you're not perfect. Some people right now are probably thinking, whoa, no. Innkeeper, no. So weird. I think it's just the way the art style kept changing for everything. It made it equally, well, not equally, it made it so creepy. Just the way the art style was played around. It was beautifully done, I might add, for its time. Just the artistic value of having things just slightly change, or even then just dramatically change from 2D perspectives, I suppose. Sort of cartoon 2D. I'm not too sure what kind of design they're going for, but then it all of a sudden becomes this three-dimensional sort of weird, very potato sort of Wallace and Gromit looking design all of a sudden, which is just very weird, and especially the things they showed, especially like I said, the whole You're Not Perfect episode, as it were, that just came out of nowhere. Very creepy. Very, very creepy. And then of course, you know, Return the Slab, which you should probably do. Because otherwise bad things are going to happen. I recall the last episode being about I can't remember the names of the old couple. The Courage ended up sort of living through their lives when as them being puppets, sort of string puppets. It was very weird at the time. It was actually a projection of society. Just I feel like someone would say that. How do you not know this, Innkeeper? God. I don't know. I just am not over-analytical of these things. You can be over-analytical. That's like everyone during Game of Thrones saying, oh, this is foreshadowing. Oh, no, fuck, it's not. Or, oh, no, my theory didn't come to life. This show's shit. Like, oh, great. Oh, this really obvious thing happened, mostly because everyone's data mining the shit out of the show, and it's really hard to make something not already predicted come true, because people are predicting the absurd, and then some people are predicting the obvious. But you know what? Ah, it's fine. there we are. It still worked out well. That was my little rant right there. It really pissed me off, reading what people put down, and their predictions not coming true, and then others' predictions coming true, and how predictable the show is. And, you know, stuff like that. It's hard to not be when you have thousands and thousands and thousands of people data mining the shit out of it. Not to mention they're based off the books. I mean, I guess they're beyond that of the books right now, but you can kind of guess what's going to happen. I can't myself. No, it's that kind of show, I suppose. Although, it did start off with the whole, you know, oh, there's no plot armor anymore, but now there is plot armor. Come on. Mostly because we're out of the realm of the books, so the show does have a certain level of predictability. and favorite characters, and if you get rid of those favorite characters, then, you know, you're doing the show a disservice, obviously. Anything could happen. They could have a referendum or something. They could have a referendum in Westeros. A Westerendium. Westerendium sounds like a great sort of book. I'd read that, the Westerendium. Right, if everyone could just sort of make their way down there, that would be fantastic. You're all a little bit stuck down there. That is not great. You can move ever so slightly. Or at least you should be moving ever so slightly. Right, go on. Try it. You went down. I recall you just going straight down and then back up again. It was really strange. There are some other shows. Some other cartoons that I recall watching. But they're not coming up in my old noggin. Old Dexter's Laboratory. That was a very good one. Anything else that was pretty good? I can't recall anything else. But it was all pretty good. They were pretty good. Yeah, I wouldn't watch them now, though. Well, no, then again, I would watch them now. Oh, SpongeBob as well. Can't forget old SpongeBob right there. No, can't forget good old SpongeBob. Not that much of SpongeBob, though. But I did watch it. Also, I think the A series of Pokemon, I can't remember. I remember collecting the cards, but I wasn't that into it. I've not played the games, really. I don't really have any desire to. I suppose it's like Pokemon Go. I just don't have any desire. I watched the show. It's all right. So, yeah. It's all right. It didn't really have any impact on me as it did many others. Not sort of belittling your opinions or anything like that. They are fully acceptable. Not like, oh, you like Pokemon, do you? No one probably knows what I'm saying when I do that. Well, the person said, who probably should have some sort of weird sort of, like, name, really, as some sort of another personality. I don't know. But you can't understand him. He's an old bugger, let me tell you. Very old, set in his ways. Keyword bastard, generally used to associate with that person. But yes. As for documentaries, I can't really name them off the top of my head. I suppose there are a few. I still watched a few documentaries that were, for the most part, reality stuff, like Bear Grylls, which was... It was fun to watch. Obviously, lots of people, whenever you mention it, go, oh, yeah, and like, most of the time he's not really doing any of this stuff, and it's actually really easy, blah, blah, blah. I don't really care about that. It's entertaining to watch. That's pretty much it. It's just entertaining to watch. I don't care. I've never really had that kind of... that care for media. Oh, Merv, stop it!
Oh, get out of there. Get over here.
Oh. Sorry, I was making those cotton-eating sounds, but they were becoming very, very aggressive, and I just... Oh, no! I can't be dealing with that right now. I'm too fragile. Stop. There we go. We want to get the windows in soon, once we get the top of these buildings done. Look at that. It's really helped to sort of fill up the space right there that was previously being unoccupied. However, there's just this big patch right here that I don't know what to do with. So I did say I was going to extend it and do some fun stuff with the engineering area, but I just don't know now. I just sort of want to put two houses there, but we'll see, I suppose. We could have it be a more open area. But of what, though? Pretty much it. Like, of what? Are we just going to have a bunch of storage there? I don't mind having a bunch of storage. We can put it on... I don't know. But we'll probably cover it with stone. Sort of like the brown. If we go over here. I think it's over there. There we go. Yeah, the pavestone brown. And then put boxes and sort of carts over it. Just to have some area for people to... drop their stuff off if they want to drop their stuff off around here. I should really have my... Wait, it's not on? Okay, that was a bit weird. That was a little bit strange. How's this look? It's all right. It's not too bad. It's not the first time, as we just looked a second ago, where buildings have connected to one another. All of these ones have. And it looks good, really. I'm zooming out a little bit right here. Yep, it's taking up a lot of space. It's good to see. Nearly done there. Yeah, Bear Grylls. How it's made. It's a good one. Obviously, a sort of a bunch of World War II documentaries. Not so much World War I. I know there is a YouTube World War I series, as it were. The Great War or something like that. I've not got myself around to watching. I can't recall others. I know I stopped watching once all the sort of more reality Bear Grylls kind of stuff started to pop up. Like Gold Diggers. sort of that, Gold Diggers, or what the hell was it called? Warehouse Wars or something like that. Storage Wars, that's it. Warehouse Wars. Yeah, Storage Wars, and I don't really care for those. You can tell how scripted they are, especially the bloody music. I don't like... American shows tend to do this a lot, just music. Unusually dramatic. Trying to sort of make tension that is not there. I suppose because otherwise maybe people would get bored of it or something like that. I mean, I wouldn't personally. I suppose I'm just used to not having any of this pointless music thrown into, like I said, sort of draw in people with otherwise rather short attention spans. I'm assuming that's what it's there for. I'm not trying to belittle those that don't like it. Don't like things that don't have music in them. That's my assumption. I imagine there's probably other reasons there that I'm unaware of. So there we go. Very PC of you, Innkeeper. Very PC. Right there. So I can't really do much here. We could just have two little bits sticking out. Where am I sticking them from? So I'm two blocks up, so that's fine. One right there perhaps. I'm okay with that. This one I feel like we could have... I don't know, actually. One right here, one right here. I suppose we're about to find out what it looks like from the back. So we'll get both of them mined up, or at least we're hoping to. Nope. We'll wait a little while longer, I suppose. Hopefully the connector isn't too weird. It's okay, I suppose. Just get rid of that annoying flatness they previously had. So I suppose that's what I'll do. What else? What else was it on documentaries that I recall watching? Then again, I should go back to the cartoons one, The Simpsons as well, which I don't really consider to be adult cartoon myself. There is a lot of innuendo, but there's innuendo in all adult cartoons, really. I mean, I suppose it's just how dirty your mind is. You can come up with an innuendo of anything. It's not really like a special hidden talent. It's quite easy to make an innuendo. Like every time you say it, it's one, so. Oh, I accidentally left my bangers in the car. Oh, dick. There we go. Done. I'm not sure what that means. I left my bangers and mash in the car. Like, okay. I'm not sure why you've done that. Why did you bring a meal into your car like that? Or maybe they bought a ready meal. Who buys ready-made bangers and mash? Oh, that sounds revolting. Anything like that. I understand it if maybe you just don't have the ability to cook. You know, some of us only have microwaves. Not everyone can afford a proper... stove or some sort of cooker. A microwave is good enough for most jobs, and maybe you just want to have a proper meal. I mean, it's not really a proper meal. You may as well go to a restaurant or something like that. But then again, we haven't all got the money for a restaurant as well. I'm not saying I do. It, you know, maybe if you want to treat yourself, that might be the best way to do it, rather than buying a £5 meal. Less than a £5. If it's £5 and it's bad, oh no, I'm not buying that for £5. It's just really weird. It looks like a pair of eyes too close to one another. Suppose I don't care about it that much when I look back a bit. It's just sort of taking up space, really. I think the other problem I have is that the windows for some of these are not in the same locations. Yeah, they're not, are they? I'm not sure if that makes them look bad or worse. Bad or worse. I mean, good or worse. No, better or worse. There we go. No excuse to have trouble saying that. Yeah, I'm already doing that with some of these. And then these ones are just for some reason a little bit higher up. Are they? Yeah, they are. They're one block up. They look good one block up, though. Especially this one. It's going to help out having two bits here. I mean, this middle part, I suppose, is going to be blocked off a little bit. I could do that. But I don't think I want to do that. There's too much background space being used up. Having it on the low part, I think, would look kind of strange. So I think the way I'm doing it now is fine. It may mean a little bit of a makeover, I suppose, to some of these structures. To sort of some of the older ones. But I don't think we're there just yet. I want to get this side done as well. I'm going to have two parts here. So I think that's good enough. Takes up some more space. Same thing on the other side. How's that look? Yeah, that looks great. That's much better looking. Just one block higher up. Didn't do it before. Don't know why. I guess I never tested it, really. Or maybe I did test it, but now my preferences have changed. Most probably what's happened. These ones are a bit too close to one another. That's the only thing I don't like about them being one block higher up, is that they can't really spread out by a little bit. But then again, I don't make them spread out by a little bit anyway, so I suppose I can't make that excuse. Merv right there, just talking to me, telling me his day.
You had a very nice day, Merv, did you? Yeah? No. You're a little bugger, that's why.
You don't deserve a good day. All you do is cause distress. You make me worry. Like, one day you're going to come back and you're going to be on the floor and there's going to be a bunch of cables nearby and you're like, oh, fucking hell. Then again, I would never let that happen, but still, you know, that's a irresponsible owner that would do that. Someone right now is like, oh, shit.
What? Is it because I'm not paying attention to you? I don't need to look at you to show that I'm paying attention, but then again, maybe that's the only way for you to understand that I'm paying attention. I don't know. What?
I know, I could have done one. Because that looks pretty good with just one. Can we look at some of these? Oh, the game has spawned. Wow, okay. A wolf has been spotted by Emily. That's pretty bad, Emily. You're not going to have a good run by the looks of things. We will get you, Farkas. Oh, Emily's gonna die, isn't she? Wow, she got so fucked. Didn't even start. I can't take this off her. Oh, that's her dead. I mean, she might be able to fight back. I don't know why I'm not pausing here. I could turn her into an inventory. That might help out. Nope, she dead already. Wow, the game completely fucked her over. Okay. That's a bit bullshit, but okay. I guess we'll keep going. This is the only thing I don't like about going in the wild. This game is that it's very much prone to fucking you over when it comes to spawns, and also you can't really drop this stuff. But there we go. Emily came, and she died. I feel like she's probably bonded with a few people. There's been a few instances similar to that. What do you mean not enough space for you to work? Oh, there we go. Go kill that other wolf. Where the fuck is he going? Alright, come on. Take him out. We should have another wolf or a bunch of wolves lingering around somewhere. Probably could have saved her by paying attention, but then again, I can't do it all the time. That'd be absurd. Innkeeper, it's your fault every single time. Sometimes the game is just out to fuck you. Ephrael's told me this several times. He's an evil man. Why do you think 1.7 exists?
Evil, evil, evil.
Be worse in 1.7. Come out of nowhere. And they really would, because of the fog of war. And they can aggro way ahead of it. You get completely screwed over. You want to watch yourself. Watch your back, Ephrael. I'm coming for you. Emily has joined and she has died. I like how it says Emily has died and then it says enemy is slain by wolf. Seems really odd to me. There we are. Finette is going to be slain by wolf soon. Oh, wolf. To be slain by you. Okay, maybe not. Probably could have saved her. Yeah, probably could have. Instead of panicking, I could have probably gave her a fighting chance, but it doesn't look like she was really going to do anything. She started running after a while. Maybe, but we do have two other wolves. We had that wolf that was running over here, and I suppose that one that chilled out. So if I got lucky, maybe I would have killed this wolf, and the other one wouldn't have bothered with Emily, but it doesn't. Nothing's really telling me that's going to happen. I feel really bitter about that. We haven't had too many deaths in the series. I just feel like Emily never got a chance. She's dead now. She's going to be there forever. Because I can't get rid of these bloody bodies. I think I can with a forager or something like that. How are we looking on these houses? Yep, we've got our windows. I'm not really going to add any windows on these open sides. Well, I probably should. I suppose I will. Mostly because it makes a difference when we're walking around with Islay. But really, we're not going to notice. Bloody hell, it's a pain in the ass though. You know, I should really do it like this. Well, it's a little bit more of a bother when you're looking at it from this perspective, I suppose. Should be 3 blocks in from every corner. Some of them are very spaced out. In fact, this one could be double on each, yeah. There's so many room. There's so much room on some of them. There we are. And that'll be it for a good number of the... No, no, stop, wait. What am I talking about? Once again, I just went into sort of... I don't know. I went into a very odd, like, I've done mode, but I'm not done yet. We can have... these ones can be two apart instead. Apart. Oh, our. Same thing on this side. Here and here. I didn't finish my topic, did I? No, I went through documentaries. I can quickly go through the adult ones. I mean, it was more Simpsons, South Park, Family Guy, the, I think the Cleveland Show for a little while as well, American Dad. And what else was there? I think that was it. I think it was it for that sort of show off, I suppose. Not show off. For those adult, more adult anyway. Excluding the Simpsons, I suppose. Mostly South Park. South Park and Family Guy. And then it went into YouTube and mostly into just sort of panel shows and comedies, that kind of thing. I suppose not too extensive. Gaming as well, more of that. With the whole Let's Play thing sort of booming. I suppose not so much in these days, but it's still a big thing on YouTube, so I suppose it still is. But it definitely was bigger. Was it bigger? Well, no, I suppose it's still big now. But maybe more centralized than when it was. Because you got sort of more, sort of bigger channels that are still thriving. Whereas it's a lot harder now. For the channels that are trying to get out there to get out there because of all the competition. We've got these houses now, though. Very interesting, if a little bit sort of oddly spaced out discussion for today, however, in this session. Do apologize. Not my best run ever. My previous sort of playthroughs of Timber and Stone, the sessions even, have been a lot better than this one. But as I've said, I think I'm just a little bit off today. So I do apologize about that. Couldn't be helped. However, we did get a decent amount done. We finished the roofs of these buildings right here. And all of them, in fact. So we can get rid of all the scaffolding on the next episode, get the interior decoration done. We have a decent amount of wood, so we hopefully should be able to facilitate that. I know we don't. We have enough wood logs, but not actually enough planks. Okay. That's not good, is it? And we did lose Emily. But I suppose it could have been worse. It could have been someone else that we've come to... Well, become accustomed with, like Chloe the Warrior. That'd be horrible. But Emily is annoying to lose her. Gonna need her for battle, I imagine, at some point. And then it's just sort of the town's exterior. Like, we've still got a bunch of trees over here. And I'm planning to have a bunch of other trees sort of planted across the rest of our town. Just to fill up the gaps and random spaces here and there. As well as statues and random walkways and maybe a carriage here and there. Once again, to fill up space, crates, all that fun stuff. I'm looking forward to it. Hopefully it will make our town look just a little bit more real and alive, thriving, going through rustling and bustling, other random words to throw into this really poorly constructed sentence. Yeah, happy things. Hopefully you've enjoyed yourselves today, ladies and gentlemen. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, all that good stuff. Follow me on Twitter for updates on my channel and Twitch for live streams. I've been the Innkeeper. You've all been fantastic, and I'll see you all next time for some more Timber and Stone. Bye-bye.